Hey guys, my name is KJOS and Android 12 Beta 1 is finally out for the public to download, and I have been using mine now for the past 2 days. So in this video, I'm going to give you my experience with it so far, as well as the new features and what is expected in the next few betas as we go along. And without taking too much of your time, let's get this party started. The biggest and most noticeable change to Android 12 from Android 11 is the interface. The interface is very different from what you're used to, and Google is calling this new design language Material U. This basically turns the user into a co-creator because it uses the color of your wallpaper to change the color palette of your phone, and it affects everything from your notification tray, the widget system, your settings, and many others. Your wallpaper basically comes to life, and that's a very cool feature. Android in general has been lacking in the design department for a while now, so this new UI change is very much welcome to the Android ecosystem. Everything about Android 12 and its new UI interface just screams big and in your face, which isn't a bad thing to be very honest. The fonts are big, the tiles are also big, giving it a more rectangular look as opposed to a circular shape, which just makes it easier to click on what you want without any fuss. Speaking of notifications, I noticed a bug when you drop down the notification tray, and once you extend it all the way, for some weird reason, you can't swipe back up. So you need to use the back gesture for your phone to go back. Hopefully this can be fixed in the next update. Upcoming features for the notification and quick settings include configuring your smart devices in your house from your Google Home, your lights, and so many others. On Android 11, you had to press the home button to manage this feature or go to the Google Home app. Another for Google Play, and two more that is coming to let you disable your camera and mic to protect your privacy. Now, the lock screen is probably the first thing you're going to notice when you install Android 12 on your phone. It's fun and it's a great addition to have so far. For one, the clock or time animation is now more prominent and visually better. It also matches the color of your background. One of the cool things about this new home feature is the animation when picking up the phone or locking the phone. If you pick it up from the table, the screen comes up from the direction you picked it up, and if you unlock it from the power button, the animation ripples from there. When you have a notification, the big clock goes a bit smaller and moves to the left top side of the screen, showing the weather, the date, and said notification. Typing in your PIN now is aesthetically better, it's bigger and makes it a lot easier to type in your password. There are new gestures in Android 12. One of the most noticeable ones is back tap, and it's kind of like iOS where you can tap the back of your phone for a task to be done. Personally, I'm not even going to try to turn this on because just like iOS, I'm going to have accidental touches on my Pixel, and as far as I'm concerned, it's a gimmick because I'm probably never going to use it as frequently as any other feature on the phone. Under the same menu, you can also remap the power button to activate the Google Assistant. I guess everything we hate Samsung for and Bixby is finally coming to Android 12 on your Pixel. Google and Android have worked together in the background to produce an operating system that is faster and much more fluid. They've reduced the CPU time of the Android server by 22%, and I can't even measure that in real life everyday use, but so far it's pretty solid and pretty fast. A lot of things that were said during the Google I/O event are not in this beta currently. We are still expecting a few more things that are on the way in the next few coming updates. For one, we have new features that pertaining to privacy. Just like iOS 14, we can now know when our cameras and mics are being used in the background, with the green animation at the top right corner to let us know. There's also going to be a privacy dashboard in the settings that monitors the apps, the types of data accessed, when they were accessed, and basically giving an overview of what has been used, what permissions have been given, and so on. And the best part, you can easily revoke any permission from that dashboard. Widgets are also going to be revamped, and if we're being honest, Android widgets are in a dire need of change, but I honestly don't remember the last time I even used widgets on anything. There's also going to be a change to the volume slider because the current one or the beta one is kind of huge. Takes up a chunk of the screen, so the new one is going to be much more refined. We've got a new animation for bringing out the taskbar. Wi-Fi is now going to be called Internet and will bring a menu from the bottom of the screen instead of taking you to the settings. Android 12 is going to allow you to turn your smartphone into a remote for Android TV. It will enable users to type from the comfort of their phones and to project on the TV. It makes so much sense if you ask me, because I'm pretty sure anyone watching this video right now already knows how difficult it is to type a movie name on Netflix with a TV remote. Just a little heads up, Android 12 is a beta version at the moment and it's not the full thing, so you're going to encounter a few bugs along the way. And I know I saw a few articles that say it's kind of bug-free, which isn't really the case. I encountered a few bugs, like I said, and they were really annoying to use and it kind of hampered my experience on it so far. For one, when using the Twitter app, uploading a picture crashes the app totally. And the only thing you can do are two things. One, restart your phone or uninstall the app, then install the app to use it again. I had to go to my Twitter's website on Chrome for me to upload my picture, and it's pretty crazy. I really like the movement Google and Android are taking. They're calling it the biggest change in Android for a while, and they're quite spot on. It's not the perfect beta, but I'm excited to see what else is in store for Android 12 going forward. So that was a quick look on Android 12 Beta 1, and I will be updating you guys on my social medias on Twitter and Instagram when the new betas come out, so follow me if you want to stay updated. And guys, if you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up, as this helps this video go a long way in terms of visibility, and share it with your friends. And also, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to the channel, as this also goes a very long way for me. Thank you guys for watching. My name is KJOS, and I will catch you in the next one, where we talk all things tech.